Amen. Victory belongs to Jesus. I'm coming today from Ezekiel, the 36th chapter. I'm starting at the, praise God, 22nd verse. It says, therefore say unto the house of Israel, thus says the Lord God, I do not this for your sakes, O house of Israel, but for my holy name's sake, which you have profaned among the heathens, whither you went. And I will sanctify my great name, which was profaned among the heathens, which you have profaned in the midst of them. And that in you before their eyes, for I will take you from among the heathen and gather you out of the countries and will bring you into your own land. Amen. Praise God. Verse 25 says, then I will sprinkle clean water upon you, and ye shall be clean from all your filthiness and from all your idols. Will I cleanse you? A new heart also will I give you. A new spirit will I put within you, and I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh, and I will put my spirit within you, hallelujah, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and ye shall keep my judgments and do them, and ye shall dwell in the land that I gave to your fathers, and ye shall be my people, and I will be your God. I will also save you from your uncleanness, and I will, hallelujah, call for the corn, and will increase it, and will lay no famine, amen, upon you. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And I leave this thought with you, praise God. It's not, amen, for you, praise God, but it's for my glory. Hallelujah. It's not so much for you, praise God, but it's for my glory. Hallelujah. Which includes you. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. It's not so much for you, but it's for my glory, which, amen, includes you. And what the Lord was saying here to the children of Israel, amen, Israel, pray the Lord, was scattered, and they were going through rough times and hard times, hallelujah, but he was giving Israel a promise and letting them know that I'm bringing you out, amen, I'm bringing you out of this darkness, I'm bringing you out of this dark place that you have allowed yourself to enter into, amen, I'm bringing you back, amen, to the oracles of God. So many, amen, of us has left, amen, the oracles of God, those things that God has told us to do, the things that God has told us to stay away from, amen, we have found ourselves, amen, going back to them, amen, dipping and dabbing, hallelujah. But God is saying at this point, praise God, in our lives, praise the Lord, during this pestilent time, during this famine, that he's bringing us out, amen, of this idolatry worshiping, out of the things that's unpleasing to God. He says, I'm bringing you out. Amen. During this pandemic, praise the Lord, the Lord has allowed us to go through some things. But at the end of the day, God is saying that when you come out of this pandemic, praise the Lord, you should come out, hallelujah, with a clean heart. You should come out with the right spirit. God says he's giving you an opportunity, praise God, to get a heart of flesh, hallelujah. If you allow him to put the heart inside of you that he wants to give you, the heart of flesh, a heart to do good, hallelujah, then God said, during this pandemic, amen, I'm bringing you out, I'm doing that, amen. God said he's giving you salvation, praise God, if you want it, hallelujah. During this pandemic, he's bringing you out, praise God, with salvation, hallelujah. He says that he's putting the right spirit, amen, within us, praise God, within you, hallelujah. Family and friends, amen. God said he's giving you, amen, a heart of flesh, and he's putting his spirit within you. Amen. God wants to give you his spirit that you can walk in the spirit of obedience, hallelujah, to the things of God. And he's saying that he will bring us out, praise God, and there will be no more famine, hallelujah, or pestilent that will come upon us, praise God. Every child of God should not go, hallelujah, without. Praise God. God said he's bringing us out of this pandemic with more. I can say, hallelujah, during this time of pandemic, amen, I have more than I had, hallelujah, prior to going into the pandemic, hallelujah. And you as well, as you look back, amen, over your lives over these last few months, amen, you have had more than enough. Hallelujah, glory be to God. God has supplied and met every need. But I'm telling you today, praise God, if you can just walk, amen, in faith, praise God, hallelujah, and in the spirit of obedience, hallelujah, and in the spirit of sacrificing, hallelujah, sacrificing your flesh, sacrificing the things of the flesh, the things that your flesh like, the things that your flesh wants to indulge in, if you can deny those things, hallelujah, and get in the presence, stay in the presence of God, amen, and seek God to create in you a clean heart and renew the right spirit within you, amen, God has given us a promise, he's given you a promise, hallelujah, that no famine shall come upon you, and he will multiply your grain, he will multiply your corn, hallelujah. He will multiply. He will make sure that you have more than enough. I want to encourage you today and let you know, praise God, that that's going on, that the God's doing inside of you, hallelujah, that the God is doing for you, praise God, hallelujah, during these times, hallelujah, it's not for you, praise God, but it's for his glory, and it includes you in it, hallelujah, oh, praise the name of the Lord, hallelujah, it includes you in it. God is doing this that he can be glorified and that he can get the glory, so let's let God get the glory out of our lives, praise God. Let God be glorified in you. Let God do in you what he want to do. Hallelujah. During this time, praise God. Let's walk in the spirit of obedience. I love you. Hallelujah. And may heaven forever smile upon you is my prayer.